was music coming from the past. It was in this room that Dr. Charles Fourier took the maid as his mistress. And it was here that he savagely murdered his wife, Sarah, then buried her under the organ's pipes and the reeds. Soon the doctor and maid were married. People say that on their wedding night, the organ began to play. Softly at first, sadly, then increasingly louder and more maddening. Dr. Fourier tried hacking it to pieces. Still, it played on. The next morning, the doctor and his maid were found hanged from two nooses directly over the organ. The official report says guilt drove them insane. But I never believe official reports.
No one ever comes to this house on the hill anymore. At least not mortal souls. It is a gloomy place, in terrible disrepair. What once were magnificent windows are boarded shut, or stare out like vacant eyes. What once was a garden is overrun by weeds and scattered white trunks of decayed trees. I arrange the horses tight and shackle the doors. For they have a second sense of intractable terror. Cobwebs hang from the wall and furniture. There's an ominous power of darkness in such a desolate house. But you don't believe in ghosts, do you?
Thank you.
How curious. The fireplace burns in the dining room. And the table has been set. What's this? A wooden coffin.
Come to me. What of my flesh of my flesh. Come to me. Come, come. Good evening. I've been expecting you.
He casts no shadow, shows no blood in his face. His hands are hairy, his teeth sharp, his eyes daggers of fire.
You seem restless, my friend.
Doors everywhere, all bolted.
I am the darkness and the night, a shadow in your dreams. Do you hear them? The creatures of the night. My children of darkness. They sing a requiem for the dead and undead. I shall return. Kill them.
Please. I trust you like salad with a balsamic vinegar.
I find that stink so. So bad for the heart. Tonight, I take a bride. Blood of my blood. Flesh of my flesh. Come with me into the darkness. And you shall know eternal life. I'm afraid you swooned, so we placed you on this table. Please, don't fight the straps. Just look toward the ceiling of your prison. Do you see the painted picture of time? rather than the traditional scythe. He's holding a huge pendulum.
Yes, the pendulum is in motion. Notice how its arc and velocity increase with every swing.
Notice how it lowers inch by inch, a crescent of sharpened glittering steel, about a foot in length from horn to horn, the under edge as keen as a razor.
The pendulum is designed to cross the region of your heart.
First it splits your clothing, then returns and repeats the operation. Feel the sharp, cold steel upon your skin.
Just a tickle at first, then a trickle of blood.
Then...
When through the cemetery gate, along the overgrown path, be careful where you tread. There's really nothing to worry about just here. Is there? Everyone knows that manifestations of the supernatural are but figments of the imagination. Everyone knows that, don't they? Don't they?
A little museum. It's nothing very remarkable, really. Just an odd collection of medieval tools.
Care to lose your head over a guillotine?
I see you have an eye out for that hot poker.
Oh, ever get stretched on a rack? Ah, yeah. One of my personal favorites. The ancient Chinese water torture. To the last drop. Snake pits are, well, foolish. A turn of the century dental drill. They were slower then, much hotter too, but quite effective in getting to the root of the matter. Sorry, did I touch a raw nerve?
if you walk through Witch's Wood, past the hanging tree, then down Dead Man's Lane, over the wooden footbridge past Creepy Hollow, you will come to an ancient graveyard. They say it isn't safe for mortals to be here, especially after dark. But here is a place of twilight, a place occupied, they say, by half-beings. A twilight world of spirits, of ghosts, of ghouls and banshees, and apparitions from the netherworld of darkness and cold. Disembodied souls, lost forever in purgatory. This is a place of black foreboding, a stark and terrifying area of strange and dreadful. Most people whistle bravely to themselves as they pass this locality, or try to, in spite of a sudden dryness of the mouth and quickening of the heartbeat. We are all brave enough when we can't actually see what's lurking behind us.
You've entered the wrong door. And you're not coming out alive!
Laboratory where frightful experiments are conducted.
Thank you.
let that door close behind you. Don't panic. There must be another way out of this dark, dank, musty house of the dead. That's not Jack Frost nibbling at your toes. There's hundreds of enormous rats scurrying all around, growing bolder by the moment. Fierce red eyes and ravenous sharp fangs, lured by the scent of fresh meat. You. Quick. There's a hint of light coming from the far corner. Drop the lamp on this rotted wood to keep the rats at bay. And run. Run for your life. Terrible storm, and all the lights have gone out. You awaken, not to thunder, but to the incessant beat of a heart under your bed. Do you dare look under the mattress, or with trembling fingers pull the covers high over your head? When an otherworldly chill is in the air, and the wind calls your name, when the hounds bark, as if possessed, do you raise your collar and quicken your pace, or laugh at your fancy imagination? Could you spend the night alone in a house by the sea, a house where the walls cry and the spirits are restless? But you don't believe in such nonsense, do you? Not in ghosts, or ghouls, or vampires. Not in raising the dead, or tales of terror, or the black eye. So come, come with me past this wrought iron fence. Some call this place the Valley of Unrest, but it's just an old graveyard, a place of everlasting sleep.
nothing here but crumbling headstones overrun by grass and weeds. Large tombs, foreboding and long forgotten. Decaying trees with claw-like branches that dip into the surrounding mist. Hold that lamp high. The night is stars, and the moon rides on dark, ominous clouds. Side is a town of the living, of warm hearts and cheer. They say this cemetery is a shortcut, though the locals never walk it, at least not after dark. They talk of ghosts and spirits and screaming banshees, of disembodied souls lost in a netherworld between life and the hereafter, of premature burials where victims cry out with their final breath, of the uninvited who stalk these grounds, though if truth be told, it is we who are truly the uninvited. Good thing we weren't standing under that tree. Dead Man's Hill. Somehow we've become lost in the swirling mist and lashing rain, surrounded in every direction by pillars and headstones and tombs. Can you hear the beating of your heart? Feel the hair on your neck stand? What horrible fate befell those who tread this path before us?
Listen. Midnight. The witching hour.
Familiar captain, jet black crew, flying broomsticks, thrice times woe. I'll place a spell upon your head, spit three times, and then you're dead. Entrails, dragon's breath, tongue of lizard, certain death.